A micrometer is a precision measurement tool used to measure thickness, depth, and other measurements. Fairly simple tool to use, but I want to explain to you how it works. The three basic components of a micrometer you need to remember are the anvil, which is the stationary end, the spindle, which is the little shaft that extends out, and the thimble, which is the part you turn. A micrometer measures by the use of precision ground threads inside of here, 40 threads per inch. If I take 1 inch and divide it by 40, it gives me 25 thousandths of an inch. So one full rotation of the thimble is 25 thousandths. And there are graduations both on the stationary and the movable side of the micrometer that give you those dimensions. So I want to show you a little more about these marks and dimensions and how this works. So with a micrometer run all the way in, I can see that the mark on the stationary side aligns with zero on the movable side. That's zero. If I open it up to the first mark, that's a thousandth of an inch, two thousandths, three, four, five. I also have larger increments for every five thousandths. So that would be 10, 15, 20, all the way around to 24, and the next would be 25. And I see the first mark emerging on the stationary side of the micrometer. That tells me that that would be 25 thousandths. One more full rotation will get me to 50 thousandths, and there's a second mark. Another full rotation to 75, and a third mark. And a fourth rotation all the way back around, and I can see the one emerging here. That would be 100 thousandths of an inch. And I can continue on to 125, 150, 175, and as I come back around again, I see the two emerging. That would be 200 thousandths. And you just continue this all the way out till you come to a full 1 inch of measurement. Micrometers are graduated in 1 inch, so you can have a 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and so on. Some actually have replaceable spindles where you can use one frame or one body of the micrometer and measure from 0 up to 12 inches. So I've picked up a bolt here. I don't know exactly the size of the threads, but I have some idea. But I'm going to measure it with a micrometer now and to see what the diameter of these threads are. So I'll place the bolt very carefully until I feel a little bit of pressure against it. I'm not going to squeeze it too tightly, just a gentle touch. And I can see that the diameter of these threads is about 307 thousandths of an inch. And since I know that threads typically run just a little bit smaller than nominal size, the next fractional size up would be 5/16 or 0.3125. So I know this is a 5/16 bolt. I could measure the head of it if I wanted to know if I needed to put a very accurate wrench on it. And it is just under 500 thousandths of an inch, so I know it requires a half inch wrench. Now there are all different types of micrometers. This is a little old school with a vernier gauge. You can get digitals, which are a lot easier to read, but still require a little bit of practice. But with a little practice and patience, you can get very good and take very accurate readings with a micrometer.